Fantastic project from Gateshead, where the young carers can go anytime after school, they kind of do social stuff together, they get a real respite from the pressure that's on them here in the home. And that project, interestingly, in this downturn which we're talking about, is threatened by the fact that the local authority is under pressure. It hasn't got as much money as it used to have, the order or rent on that, or the banks and local colleges. And so the money from common relief to keep that little kind of rural home and build that of optimism going in that community in Gateshead is crucial.
Let's bring in Judith, who's called us from Thetford in Norfolk. Hello, Judith.
Hello.
You say you won't be donating to Comic Relief. Tell us why not.
Well, it's basically, it's a case of telling the old story. For years, we've heard about the poor African children have coughing, have insults and suffering, so many pounds will go to buy them a bowl of rice for tea, and they'll be well able to survive. Let me tell you something. If I was in debt, I'd have to sort myself out. I'd have to manage my own affairs. If I continuously came to you and said, "Thank you, the £250, please," perhaps initially for the first time you'd say, "Yes, no problem," and you'd give me the £50. A few weeks later, I'd come back to you and say, "Could you lend me another £50? And I'd say, "Well, possibly, yes, okay." If I continuously chose that I could manage my affairs, you perhaps would be rightfully concerned. I also try to remember, we have been continuously bailing out these charities in Africa. And is it any wonder why we continuously bail them out? Of course they will not help themselves. They'll think, "Oh, we have these lovely people from other countries, and they'll send us the money, but we'll not have to work for it."
No, they continue to do it. All right, Judith, let's pick that point up with Kevin. What do you say to that? Because some people will say, "We've heard this story many, many times before, and nothing seems to change. Why is it that we have continually to give money to people who don't seem to be able to sort themselves out?"
Well, I'd say that things are changing, and that things take a long time to change. Go to the bowl of rice analogy. Probably it doesn't fund bowls of rice. It funds things more like education programs, you know, kind of educating women who can take more responsibility in their own families, helping people, say, don't end with HIV, AIDS, build the kind of community support structures to get themselves through it and to become well again, so they become productive members of society. When I visited Rwanda just after the genocide in 1994, we met a group of women whose husbands had been killed, whose families had been killed in the genocide. And simply by giving them a small loan, I met a woman who had borrowed $100, bought 100 chickens, she could start laying eggs. She sold the eggs. She was then able to pay back the loan rather quickly. The loan went back into the central fund, went to another woman to start another business. So I think it's important to realise that actually things are changing. GDP in Africa, in many countries, is increasing at a high level than it is in the UK. There are 18 new democracies across Africa since the mid-1990s. So the notion that you can kind of categorise it all as one thing and just say, "Well, it's all in." There are signs of progress. There are 40 million children, more children in school in Africa since the beginning of since the year 2000.